I have two parts in my speech. First part, I will give an idea about the democratic process of Turkey from the historical perspective. First, establishment of parliament to 1920 and Republic of Turkey 1923. Immediately after the establishment of the Republic, first constitution prepared and accepted by parliaments in 1924. Later, in 2007, some amendments was done. 1934 woman suffrage, right of woman to vote and stand for electoral office. Before then, many countries, including some advanced democracies such as France, Italy, and Switzerland. First free election, multi-political party system in 1946. It was an open vote but secret count. And second free election, 1950, then the founder of the Republic. Republican People's Party lost the and Democrat Party, Conservative Liberal Party won the election. Then during the all the 50s, 10 years, control execution and with very high majority to became end of the period somehow authoritarian regime. The first military intervention appeared in 1960 and military force took over the power and closed down the Democrat Party. New constitution put in place 1961, introduced this institution introduced social fairness, labor unions, and unification plan, planet economy perspective into the constitution. After this constitution, new free election in 1963, new coalition between central right and left political parties. Again, early 70s, another military intervention. Memorandum not to government and established a technocrat-dominated coalition government. 70s again, youth movements, socialist-oriented groups versus counter-nationalist. Then late 70s, severe economic crisis, partly due to the oil crisis, partly internal conflicts. Then macroeconomic policy decisions were taken in 24 January 1980. This is one of the important step in Turkish economy. Substantial cutdown of subsidies, including energy, agricultural input, sugar, tea, many other consumer goods. Closed down some state-owned enterprises, and accompanied high inflation put heavy pressure of citizens in that time. Then Turkish government agreed an economic stabilization and structural adjustment program with the IMF in April 1980. Then again military intervention and military took over the power again. September 12, 1980. Political parties closed down, leaders being imprisoned, all labor unions, association, almost all civic society organizations, even cooperatives were closed down. Socialist students, some national student youths were imprisoned, all political books collected and prohibited, even daily journals. After new constitution again 1982, It's cut down many social rights and somehow autocratic constitution. I am not expert on constitution, but 1980s created a climate for Turks-Islam paradigms. It is important. This, let's say, Sunni Turks ideology. Free election of parliament late 1983, with political parties were allowed by military forces, National Security Council. Liberal Democrat Mother Party won the election and governed under the condition of military observatory, no social unrest, focus on economic liberalism, external trade and infrastructure. The 80s, the Turkish economy perspective switched from closed economy to open market economy. And export-led growth model preferred, and export sector supported, and export business created. Late 1980s, fiscal liberalism put in place. Turkish economy opened up to international money flow and foreign direct investment. And also 80s, the first period of the privatization. 1987 national referendum to remove ban on previous political leadership. Mother Party was against this freedom and lost referendum. 1991 government of Mother Party and new coalition established between Social Democrats and Liberal Democrats. 1994 severe economic crisis, but at the same time we had custom union agreement with the EU 1995. Before 1993, association agreement signed with the EU European Economic Community in Ankara. We called Ankara Agreement. Also 80s, 50s Turkey was accepted to be member of the NATO. This 90s again, general election 1995, political power among parties changed significantly after the severe economic crisis, and welfare party, we can identify conservative Islamic party, increased voters, and new coalition set up between welfare party and conservative liberal party. Again, February 28, 1997, a postmodern military intervention initiated and coalition government was collapsed and welfare party closed down. After this period, general election 1999, a new coalition among three parties was born. This 2000s, severe economic crisis 2000 and 2000, new economic program put in place in 2001 called Transition to Powerful Economy. 80% growth rate in 2002. But immediately election after this program, in November 2002, Conservative Democrat Party, it was established 2001, won the election. Three mainstream political parties stay out of parliament due to the 10% national threshold. The remarkable economic growth during 2002 and 2008, 865% average. EU full membership negotiations started in 2005. Many legislative reforms towards alignment with the EU put in place. And the Conservative Democrat Party, AKP, increased its voter support through the consolidation of central right parties' supporters, also partly due to the weak opposition parties and also EU orientation. The early 2000s, there was also again social policy reform period. For instance, unemployment insurance system was born and put in place. Now it is very strong, one of the richest forms in Turkey. Also, social commission, high level social commission set up, composed of worker unions, enterprise unions, and government official, government bureaucrats, and academicians to discuss and take decision about macroeconomics and social policies. And social assistance system reform and the better institution targeted and conditional assistance system put in place. It is working very well now. It is in terms of absolute term budget allocated to the poor segment of society and low socio-economic class has increased tremendously. Now it is 1.5% of GDP, but reaching around 18 million citizens. Only 2 million households are receiving heating support. Also, a wage adjustment started 1999. Between 1999 and 2002, it was according to the past inflation. Government automatically adjusted the wage, public wage and minimum wage, according to inflation rate, plus some welfare from the economic growth, 1%, 2%. After 2003, the adjustment process changed. And public servant salary has been adjusting according to expected inflation rate, not the past. But there is a mechanism to depend on the negotiation between the unions and government. In some time, government pay. Differences between the past inflation and actual inflation. But the unsure is expected inflation. Also, during this year's mid 2000s, the budget for health system and education increased. For instance, the budget allocated for education from the government was around 2-3% of GDP in early 2000, now around 5% of GDP. Around 4% of GDP education. Health used to be, it was 3% of GDP early 2000, now around 5% of GDP. Then Turkish GDP also increased due to the economic growth. So in both in terms of absolute term, in terms of percentage of GDP, health budget and education budget increased too much that majority of people can access to health system, health service, including medicine, high quality health service. On majority of the young generation access to university education, Now around one third of population can access the higher education system in Turkey. There are around 170 universities. 100 is public universities, no without tuition, free of charge. So also, starting in 2005, government provided stationery package to poor students, free textbook to all primary school students. Present history. In 2010, there was a referendum on constitution amendments. 2010, and ruling party offered 25 articles to referendum and obtained 58% of support. And after referendum, ruling party took power to control justice system and initiated negotiation with religious community, Shias in Turkey we call Alevi, Romans and also Kurds ethnic group. Created very high expectation, but nothing has given yet. It is long-lasting negotiation. Many journalists were imprisoned, around 100. Higher-ranking soldiers were imprisoned due to the accused of military intervention to government. But widely believed that with artificial events, partisan prosecutors and judges. Too many cases on corruption has appeared, including founder of the AKP and government appointed higher-level state servants, national exam for university entry, partisan public employment, including technocrats. Intervention to private life with many cases such as illegal listening and record of talking, prohibition of abortion, intervention of students' life choice, loudly complaint about sharing house by boy and girls together, new compulsory education system introduced, 4+4+4, which allows students to choose distance learning after first 4 years. It is opened a door for the some organization like IEMed group, some religious group to deal with the students. Restriction on alcohol use and purchase, not for to protect child and youth, but for adult persons. Then this was some previous realities in Turkey before to protest on street. Protests in Turkey started late May 2013, initially to contest an urban development plan which was about to convert Gezi Park, located in Istanbul center, into a complex with new mosque and shopping center in the heart of Istanbul. An environmental protest to save 600 trees in Gezi Park quickly turned into nationwide political demonstration against the current government. The good economic performance of past decade between 2000 to 2012 has dramatically improved the income and living standard of vast majority of Turkish citizens. Against this situation, protests were occurred with active participation of new generation of young, educated and employed middle class, including the doctors, including the lawyers, including the engineers, including the women, including the activists and civil society. Gezi Park protest, this is the picture, says message from the Gezi Park to government, do not bother me, please. Don't interfere with my way of living. Don't bother me with your rules. Islam does not belong to you. Islam is peace, not brutality. Do not ignore other beliefs and sexual preferences. The restriction of freedom of speech was a key issue in Turkey, illustrated with the tight control of media on imprisoning journalists. It is indicative that in 2013, Reporters Without Borders World Press Freedom Index, Turkey fallen on 154th. The government has adopted an increasingly authoritarian attitude that threatened to control basic freedom of Turkish citizens. The latest measures that were undertaken by the Turkish government include the restriction of selling alcohol, anger towards the Prime Minister's recent pejorative statements on secular lifestyle, alongside its standing up against pressure of majoritarianism that occasionally rules out civil liberties of minority groups. And the hegemonic and patriarchal model that Erdogan represents has been criticized by Turkish feminist group. Public sphere is male-dominated. Moreover, claim on the abortion of ban following Erdogan's speech, I am a prime minister who is against birth. I consider abortion murder. Erdogan was quoted as saying by Anadolu agency. Public position and job calls for the graduates of Imam Hatip School, kind of theology school, which train government employed imams, were open more than the other specialization. Similarly, teachers are in the branch on religion, were hired more than teachers are in other branches, such as music, art, natural sciences. So the final picture is from the Gezi Park. Prime Minister, get your hand off my body.